There are many software tools that you can use for your next audio project, and we recommend a few on our Creating Audio Project software page. Today, we're going to take a look at BandLab, an online digital audio workstation, or DAW. This is a program optimized for creating music, but it's also great for other audio projects like podcasts. BandLab is available for free on Mac, Windows, and Chromebook computers, as well as iPads, iPhones, and Android devices. You can use your Humboldt Google account to log in. Once you're logged in, you'll see your past projects on the left, along with live events and other social media posts. But we're going to create a new project by clicking on that red Create button in the top right. A new project will start loading and may take a few seconds. While it's loading, you may be prompted to give permissions for BandLab to access your microphone or other devices. If you are recording directly to BandLab, be sure to allow access. Otherwise, you can ignore or deny these requests. Next, I see this screen asking how I want to start my project. I will choose a voice audio track. Now I see my project interface and I get a prompt to allow access to my Bluetooth earbud microphone. You can select another mic that is connected to your computer or block access depending on your needs. And now we have a good view of our workspace. The tracks appear in the main area with the controls for each track on the left, the timeline to the right, a button to add new tracks at the top, the main menu in the upper left-hand corner, and the project playback controls at the very top center. Here is where I can record directly to BandLab using my device's microphone. When I click the red record button, I will get a count in, which is only useful for musicians. For podcasting, just keep in mind that the recording doesn't actually start until the count in is over. And now I'm recording. I can monitor my microphone, meaning that I can hear what my mic is picking up, by clicking the monitor button on the lower left. Once you're ready, you can either hit the record button again, which will stop the recording but continue the playback, or you can hit the stop button, which will stop the recording and the playback. You will want to make a short test recording and play it back to make sure the quality is good enough. And here I can see the recording in my timeline, with waveforms where I snapped my fingers at the beginning, and where I'm speaking a few seconds in. If I double-click at the top of that recording segment, I will see the exploded view at the bottom. I can zoom in on my view with the magnifying glass icons both in the exploded view and in the timeline above. If I want to make another recording, I can hit the button again, which will automatically record over my last recording, starting at the beginning or wherever the playhead is positioned.
I can record right.
However, BandLab is an editor that doesn't delete any of your work. You can see how this works if I move my original segment down the timeline by clicking and dragging on the upper part of my segment. Now I can click and drag the left-hand edge of my original segment, and it will expand and I have my full segment back. And if I wanted to record a new track rather than recording over my original recording, I can add a new track and hit record and it will record to that new track. And now that I have multiple recordings, I can grab them and drag them around anywhere within the timeline and across tracks. There's a lot of flexibility. However, right now I'm not interested in recording. I already have my recordings, and I want to pull them in to edit them together. First, I'll delete these tracks by clicking on the three dots menu next to the name of each and select Delete. And now I have a completely empty workspace. I can drag my audio files into this space from my Documents folder. It's important to drag them all to the start of the timeline, otherwise you'll have dead air at the beginning of your recording. Once I have all these recordings in my workspace, I see that each is color-coded, and I can arrange them from top to bottom to my liking by using that same three-dot menu next to each track title. Arranging them this way is purely for my own preference and won't affect the sound quality of my project. I like to have my background music at the top, my first audio track below that, the next below that, and on and on. At any point, however, I can move things around and it won't affect the project in any way other than how things visually appear in my workspace. Now that I have things arranged how I want them, let's look at two very important controls, mute and solo. Solo allows me to listen to only the one track, like the background music. Otherwise, I'd hear everything at once and it will be hard for me to decide how to edit this first track. I can solo multiple tracks to hear just those tracks. I can click the solo button to deselect a track. I can also mute tracks, which will silence just those that are selected. And then, of course, toggle them off by clicking the mute button again. I'm going to start off by muting the last two tracks so I can focus on where my first speaker will come in after the music starts. I'm going to have them start speaking around the 5-second mark, which I can see up in the timeline. So I'll want to line up this waveform to be right at that mark. The first waveform here is a clap, so I'm ignoring that for now. Now that I have it positioned on the timeline where I want it, I can delete the start of the track to delete that clap. But I'll need it in a minute, so I'm not going to do that quite yet. Next, I will fade my music out so that as the speaker begins speaking, the music gets quieter. To do this in BandLab, I'll use the automation tool. With this tool selected, I now see a volume level line for each segment. I can click on this line to create points where I can shift the volume level. So around 4 seconds, I will create a point, and then at 6 seconds, I'll create another, and then drag this point down to the bottom. This is signified as negative infinity decibels, which means no volume. The result is that the music fades slowly from full volume to none over 2 seconds. Next, I want to sync up my two voice recordings. When these two people recorded over Zoom, one of them clapped, and that clap was picked up by both microphones, and I can visually see those claps and line them up to sync the two tracks. I can zoom in to see better and fine-tune things. Once the clap is pretty well synced up, it doesn't need to be perfect, I can see from the waveforms that as the first speaker stops, the second speaker starts up. So if you didn't clap in your recordings, you can do your best by trying to line things up like so. And now that things are in position on the timeline and synced up, I can delete the claps by clicking and dragging the edges of the segments. Now let's look at the levels. We can see the waveform of the background music, which has been well edited. The peaks hit the upper and lower limits of the segment. But in our voice recordings, the peaks are far from upper and lower limits. This means that I have a lot of room to boost the level. When I double-click the top of the segment and open it in the exploded view, I see the region gain level. When I click and drag this, it increases the level of the track, and I see the peaks get closer to the upper and lower limits. If I raise the level too high, the peaks will be clipped and I will hear distortions in the recording. So I want to raise it high enough that it doesn't touch the limits, but gets close. I'll repeat this for all of my voice recordings. Now that things are boosted, I can hear some background noise and I can even see it in my waveforms. If I right-click the segment in my timeline, I can select Denoise, which will automatically correct that for me, and I can visually see those little waveforms disappear, indicating that when the speaker isn't speaking, there is no background noise. This Denoise feature really only works with faint background noise, white noise like ventilation systems or other things that are pretty consistent. This will not magically erase people talking in the background, or a dog barking, or a motorcycle speeding by. But I'm noticing that there is a spot where the person bumped their microphone and there is a thud sound. You can see it pretty clearly in the waveform, particularly now that there's no background noise. There are a few ways I can get rid of this unwanted sound, but let's explore a new way to use the automation tool. If I create 2 points before the thud and 2 afterwards, I can move the inner points down so that the volume level drops right when the thud happens. And though the thud is still visible in our segment here, it isn't audible anymore. It's good to create a little trough like this so that there is at least a short gradual volume drop. This will reduce the chance that the listener will be able to hear a sudden drop and raising of volume. It's like a micro fade that allows this volume shift to be smooth. Now I have my first 3 tracks dialed in. It's time to introduce the hiking sound. I will want to make sure that this sound starts up as the second speaker begins because they'll be talking about hiking, and I want to evoke this idea by creating a soundscape. So I will position it to start right as that speaker begins, and then I'll use the automation tool to fade into the hiking sound. I'll also reduce the overall volume of the hiking so that it doesn't overpower the speaker. I can do this by lowering that second automation point. And now that everything is set, I can go through and clean things up, trim the start and ends of each track, listen to playback, and make any other adjustments. Making small changes and then playing things back and repeating this over and over until you have it just how you want is the process of audio editing. For most class projects, you don't want to get too caught up in making everything perfect. Just be sure that all of your audio levels allow for your listener to understand any of the speaking parts. Thank you.
Thank you.